Not too much, but I got into the script knowing that there were so many good dialogues. So that was how I got involved in it.
Hero banna kaun chahta hai? Main to villain hoon. Mujhe acha banne ka koi shauk nahi hai.
Well, it was more challenging because the character is very, very different from what I am. She's a girl who comes from Kashmir, a small town, to Mumbai to become an actress, not because she wants to, but because she needs to support her family. I haven't had to do that. While she's in Mumbai, she meets these two gangsters, Shoaib and Aslam. I've never met a gangster in real life, so that's something I can't relate to either. So it was quite challenging.
Met a gangster.
Who? You? Ekta, yes. Other than that. But so it's very different from something that you and I would call relatable. It was challenging more than anything. I think Once Upon a Time in Mumbai, Dobara is the best follow-up to a performance like Lutera. It's again a very challenging role. It's a pivotal role. It's a love triangle, so the girl does have a very important part to play in the film, in the narrative. So yeah, I think it's the best follow-up after a film like Lutera.
The difficulty, I think, is the same really for any actor. It is about convincing an audience and convincing people of that character that you're playing. Ultimately, as actors, we become recognizable, we become famous, and people start to have a certain idea, a certain impression of us. They know your name, they know your face, they know a lot about you, whether you're married, you have children, who you're dating, who you fight with. All of these things become attached to your face, and it becomes more and more difficult to make people forget that and think of the character. That is always a big challenge. It was honestly one of the most valuable experiences that I've had. When you're doing anything and you get to learn from someone who has so much skill, so much knowledge and so much experience, it always makes you better. It gives you a whole new perspective. Now, whether you're doing hand-to-hand combat scenes, glass breaks, falls, high jumps, various kinds of stunts, and they're all different, and there are different risks and different aspects you have to take into account. There's not a single stunt that he has not personally improved by saying, yeah, why don't you try this, why don't you look at this, be careful of that. Every single time these little valuable nuggets of wisdom would come in, and I say, shit man, I wish I'd thought of that, I wish I knew this before.
I just want to follow wherever my heart takes me, and whatever I feel is good, whatever I want. I don't have a thought behind it, ki I don't want to calculate it, I don't want to think about it much. I have always had a career just like that throughout my life, since I've been in this industry, and I've never given too much of a thinking thought to it. My programming is like that. I just go wherever my heart takes me. If I feel good about a role, if I feel good about something, I just do it. I would love to do it. I would love to do it.
These two are anyway biting my head off. They would love it.
I would jump at the chance to do that, yeah.